Children, now you know what are rational numbers and how to do the basic operations with rational numbers. Now let us consider one example. All of you look at the board. 1/3 plus negative 2/3. 1/3 is a rational number. Also negative 2/3 is also a rational number. Then find the sum of these two rational numbers. Here denominators are same, so write the common denominator. And 1 plus negative 2, add the numerators. So we will get negative 1/3, which is also a rational number. Here we added two rational numbers and we got the sum as again a rational number. This is true for every rational number. So we can say that rational numbers are closed under addition. This is called closure property of rational numbers. Suppose A and B are two rational numbers, then A plus B is also a rational number. If A and B are two rational numbers, then A plus B is also a rational number. This is called closure property of rational numbers. Now we can take subtraction of rational numbers. Here 2/5 is a rational number. Negative 3/8 is also a rational number. We have to subtract 2/5 minus negative 3/8. You know, for subtraction you have to take additive inverse and add. So we can change this as 2/5 plus then plus 3/8. Positive 3/8. Here 5 into 8 is the LCM. So it will be 2 into 8 plus 3 into 5/14, which is equal to 16 plus 15 means 31 by 40, which is also a rational number. So if we have take 2/5, a rational number, negative 3/8, another rational number, we subtracted it and we got 31/40, again a rational number. That means the difference of any two rational numbers is also a rational number. That means rational numbers are closed under subtraction. Then next is multiplication of rational numbers. Here 2/8 is a rational number. Negative 3/5 is also a rational number. Their product 2 into negative 3/8 into 5, which is equal to negative 6/14. Short form negative 3/20, which is also a rational number. That means the product of any two rational numbers is also a rational number. That means rational numbers are closed under multiplication. So now rational numbers are closed under addition. Rational numbers are closed under subtraction. Rational numbers are closed under multiplication. Then next we can check division of rational numbers. That means one rational number 1/5 divided by negative 2/3. You know, for division we have to take the reciprocal of the divisor. So we will get 1/5 into negative 3/2, which is equal to 1 into negative 3 by 5 into 2 is equal to negative 3/10. This is also a rational number. Now we divided two rational numbers and we got again a rational number. But if we are dividing by 0, what will happen? We can't divide a number by 0, since division by 0 is not defined. So the division, if we are doing the division of two rational numbers, we can't say always It is the answer is again a rational number. So rational numbers are not closed, not closed under division. We can say if A and B are two rational numbers, then A plus B is a rational number. That means rational numbers are closed under addition. A minus B is a rational number. That means rational numbers are closed under subtraction. A into B is a rational number. So rational numbers are closed under multiplication. But A divided by B is not always a rational number, since division by 0 is not defined. Except 0, for other rational numbers, A divided by B is also a rational number. This is called closure property of rational numbers.